Sometimes it requires more than one conversion factor to solve a problem using dimensional analysis. The basic approach is the same. Please watch our first unit conversion video for the introduction to this method of problem solving. Remember, the general strategy is to look at the units you start with, look at the units you want to end up with, and use one or more conversion factors to get there. Starting unit times conversion factor equals ending unit. The conversion factor looks like this: ending unit over starting unit. So the starting units cancel, leaving you with the ending unit. Here are some more complicated problems that require at least a couple of conversion factors. Here's our first example. Convert 24.5 grams per centimeter cubed to kilograms per liter. Remember, put what you know on the left and what you want to end up with on the right. Leave lots of room for your work. 24.5 grams per centimeter cubed on the left equals some number of kilograms per liter on the right. We know we want to go from grams to kilograms and from centimeters cubed to liters. We can look up those conversion factors, and then we'll have to think about the right way to use them. There are 1,000 grams in 1 kilogram. So you could write 1,000 grams over 1 kilogram. That's a fraction equal to 1. You could also write 1 kilogram over 1,000 grams. That's also a fraction equal to 1. And there are 1,000 centimeters cubed in 1 liter. Again, you can write this as a fraction equal to 1. 1,000 centimeters cubed over 1 liter equals 1, and 1 liter over 1,000 centimeters cubed also equals 1. Here's where we have to be really careful. Which way do we write these conversion factors so the units cancel in our problem? 24.5 grams per centimeters cubed times 1 kilogram over 1,000 grams. Grams has to go on the bottom to cancel. 24.5 grams per centimeters cubed times 1 kilogram over 1,000 grams times 1,000 centimeters cubed over 1 liter next. Centimeters cubed has to go on the top. Check to make sure all your units cancel, and you'll be left with kilograms per liter. Multiply all the way across on the top, and multiply all the way across on the bottom. 24.5 kilograms per liter. Here's another example. You exhale 20.0 milliliters of CO2 with every breath. If you breathe 15 times per minute, how many liters of CO2 do you produce each month? Assume 30 days per month. We're starting with 20.0 milliliters per breath, and we want to end up with liters per month. That's going to require a lot of conversion factors, so leave a big space. 20.0 milliliters per one breath times 15 breaths per 1 minute times 60 minutes per 1 hour times 24 hours per 1 day times 30 days per 1 month times 1 liter per 1,000 milliliters equals some number of liters per month. Make sure your units cancel. Multiply the top all the way across and multiply the bottom all the way across. Don't forget to check your significant figures. There was a measurement of 3 significant figures in the problem, 20.0 milliliters. So we'll state our answer with 3 significant figures. 12,960,000 divided by 1,000 equals 12,960. Now let's put this into scientific notation so we can easily see 3 significant figures. Count over 1, 2, 3, 4 decimal places. 1.296 times 10 to the fourth liters per month. Now, round to 3 significant figures. 1.30 times 10 to the fourth liters per month.